Welcome back. So, I got the Toyota Tacoma in here, 2002 one. We got the front bumper for it. We got our tires. Got my fuel line, what I need. We'll figure out the rear brake line. We got everything for the alternator, the belts. So, first thing we're gonna do is get on the fuel line, get that out, and get it fixed. All right, so this line, she's got a blowout right up in here. So get this all disconnected. This gas in my suit. These are definitely interesting clips. Line off. That one is the return. This one's just a vacuum thing here, so I can just put another one on it. Look like the rodents were a little happy with this one. They pretty much ate the whole fucking thing. Oh, it's got a little down. That's probably what they did to this. Yep, they were chewing on it. Might as well just check the whole line. So they chewed all the way down into here on that side. This side too. Chew through right here, chew through right here. So that explains why it leaked. This one's got no connections. We do have hosing, two different sizes. So we're gonna have to heat these up on the ends to get this plastic line off. Let me get a torch in, get these off. Alright, so got the new line made. I'll clamp down. Everything's good. So I'll put this back in the truck. Move on to something else. Alright, so we got the new line in. We got that line patched. And plug that hole for the rear brake lines. So we should be good back here. Still need to do the exhaust, but I want to get the, I think I should do the alternator next, so let's get on that. Alright, so, gotta get that out, get the belt on. Of course I gotta take these two damn belts off, just so I can get that belt on, because it's behind those two. Yay. Alright, so we got the old one out, we got the new one. Oh, that was quite fun getting it out in there. But we did get the belt on. That was fun. Almost forgot to put it around the fan to get it on. That would have been bad. Well, we're going to take a break. My hands are sore from pulling that thing out. And we can put the new one in. Alright, so that took me quite a while. It's definitely not the right alternator, but it's the right plugs and everything. Things cocked a little bit this way, but it needs to be this way. So I had to modify the bottom bracket, but I've got it on. So hopefully this should work. Go get some water and antifreeze so we can fill the system up and we can see if this works. All right, let's get it started and see what is leaking and what's not, and if the water pump's gonna work. I think I popped a fuse, so I've got to go through.
Figured it out.
One of the main fuses, so see if she'll start now. So that alternator will not work. Such a drag.
So I think I got head gasket because I filled it up. It didn't really want to start, but she's smoking. Yeah, we got head gasket. Damn it. That's never good. But we did get it started, so looks like we're doing good on that part. Now the next part is gonna be head gasket, I guess. I didn't want to do that. Well, that was fun to start.
So that I was not expecting. That's probably why I got the truck so freaking cheap, because I thought it was just because, you know, this thing's all locked right the fuck up.
Well, obviously we have head gasket, so it's probably why it's all wet down in there. Yeah, see. So, I guess that's going to be the next thing to do.
Well, besides, like, the exhaust, a fucking bumper. Oh, I didn't want to do a head gasket. Maybe I can get away with it with some of that sealant. Radiator fucking head gasket stop leak. Maybe we can get that to work. Oh, I guess we'll give that a try tomorrow. Oh. But that's definitely wet. Let you blow water out, that's for sure. Oh, yeah, shop's definitely smoky now. Not nearly as bad as it was. I guess we'll try head gasket sealer first. If that doesn't work, then I guess we're pulling the whole top end and we get to do top end things. So, till next time.
Later.